What's up guys, my name is Tia and we're back with another Pentatonix song. Today we're reacting to The Sound of Silence by Pentatonix, another really requested song by you guys. I was thinking between this and your mean one, Mr. Grinch and everything. I'm gonna react to the Mr. Grinch one probably next, but today I decided to go for The Sound of Silence. So yeah guys, I don't know what to say. I can't wait to check this out. So yeah guys, let's not waste any more time and get into it. Okay guys, Pentatonix, The Sound of Silence. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Depression.
Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence.
In restless dreams, I walked alone.
Okay.
Narrow streets of cobblestone. Need the halo of a street lamp. I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light that split the night and touched the sound of silence.
And in the naked light I saw
Matt.
10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking. People hearing without listening. People writing songs.
I really like this song, by the way, guys. Like, the way it sounds is just awesome. Wasn't expecting that, really. Wasn't expecting this to be just, it's better than I thought. Really, it just shows how well they mix in overall as a group. And Matt, again, Matt, man. This guy sings so good. This guy, alright, you guys told me to react to this also, specifically to hear out Matt, because now I'm kinda on that Matt journey and everything. I wanna hear him out, you know. My guy is Avi, but my guy is also Matt now. I mean, just, he's really good. He's really good. This song is just a masterpiece so far. So, yeah. Let's continue.
It's never said, no.
Wow, Matt, okay.
Just the sound of silence.
Yeah, wow. I wanna hear a cursing solo, what's going on? There we go. Alright guys, in pretty much every song so far on Pentatonix, I was really giving props mostly to Avi, Mitch, and Kevin. But I kinda mislooked Scott and Kirsten. I really didn't give much props, just said a few comments about them and then just moved on. You know, I didn't really gave them the props they deserve because they are really talented, and without them this group won't be Pentatonix without them, really. Just Scott, another song where he takes over from the get-go. He did this, he did it on the last one too. Scott is really good. He just he he just can't do it all. He actually can do it all. Like, in a couple of songs, you know, in Hallelujah, you told me that he's taking bass and everything. A lot of, in a lot of other songs, he is like the lead singer. But Kirsten, I don't see her actually singing a lot of songs. But when she does, it's exceptional. Like, she is just really, she just mixing with the group so well. She, they need that angel's voice, and she has it. And she has really lots of power in her voice. She can go high too. I really think that she haven't showed so far the best she can do, in my opinion. I don't think she have showed, you know, so far her talents. I think that Kevin showed it a lot more. Scott, Mitch, pretty much everybody. She, like, I'm kind of underlooking her, maybe. I want the next song, guys, that you suggest to be more, like, I want to hear more Kirsten singing, actually. Even it's on PTS song. Maybe I should listen to a Kirsten solo. I really want to pay more attention to Kirsten and Scott, actually. Because I've been intrigued so far with the bass, mainly. Like Avi and Matt, specifically. I've been intrigued so much with the bass that I really forgot the other members, man. I know, Mitch. I'm giving Mitch props every time. But Scott and Kirsten, it's now your time. Your time is coming, specifically in this channel, to be recognized. So I'm embracing you from now on. Look at Scott, though. How am I overlooking this guy? Look at Kevin, the walking drunk. And whispered in the sound of silence. Man, it's really not fair how good they are. It's unfair. It's really unfair. This song is on my top of my PTA songs. This is my favorite PTA song. It just overtook Bohemian Rhapsody for the first place of my favorite songs. The Sound of Silence, that's it. That's my favorite song right now of PTX. Really, I like that each and every single one of them showcase. I kind of missed Mitch actually sang them. Each and every single one of them showcased a lot in this song, and I'm happy about that. That's why I liked Bohemian Rhapsody, because over there also each and every single one of the PTX members took part in the song in a big way, and here it was the same, and this was even this just sounded better for me. So yes, guys, officially Sound of Silence is my favorite PTX song for now. It takes the first place out of all the songs we reacted. This is it. This is the first place. It's taking it, and I don't know who is taking it over. But we will continue to react, guys, to PTX. Man, I'm so glad that I am deep into this journey. I officially feel myself as a fan, because in my actual free time, I do listen to some PTX songs. Yeah. Like, I listened to the Daft Punk version of their song. What was the other one? When their originals, I reacted to one of their songs too, but I just forgot the name of the songs. Like, man, I'm listening to some PTX lately, because, you know, I like them. I just like them. It's my type of music, what they sing. It's just really on spot, and this song is gonna be added again to my playlist, like, no cap. We'll keep on listening to them, and I can't wait to react to some more PTX songs, man. Keep them coming, guys. See, you know what you're requesting. You request nothing but the best so far, guys. I'm glad that I have so many options to choose, but now, like I said during the video, I wanna pay attention a little bit more to Kirsten and Scott, maybe. I wanna hear a song where they taking over a little bit more. You know, I've been overlooking them. Like, I haven't just paid a lot of attention to them. I've been so excited with Mitch and Avi, especially with Avi, man. Avi is my guy. I'm gonna give him praise every time, even if I'm not reacting to one of his songs or when he was in PTX. And now I'm giving a lot of props to Matt too. I'm a big fan, guys, of the bass, by the way, because I used to sing bass. I was in a group. It was church music. We were singing church music with a group. We were like 30 kids when I was a little bit younger. I was like, I sang there like 6 or 7 years. So really, I was really singing bass. I was singing bass in the group with a couple of other guys. Most of them were singing, you know, the high notes, like first tone and second tone, like we call it specifically. And I was one of the guys that sang the second tone. I was able to do them both, but I was singing mostly bass. I was having a lot of trouble teaching the bass. They really wanted me to teach the bass. My teacher thought I had the potential to have some good bass, so I really worked on that a lot. I remember like when I was like fifth grade, I was singing at home. I was training my bass so bad, and it's pretty hard to sing it into a church music, you know. It's one of the most coolest things I've ever done, actually, now that I think of it. I'm just, yeah. And now that's my explanation of why I'm paying so much attention to Matt and Avi specifically, because I used to sing that. I used to sing that back in the days. So yeah. But yeah, guys, like I said, I want some more Scott and Kirsten to hear them up a little bit more, even if it's separate songs of theirs. I gotta check it out. So yeah, guys, again, thank you for requesting this. It took me, I speaked a little bit more than usual this time, but yeah, I had some things I wanted to say. It just came out. So yeah, guys, again, thank you so much for watching. Keep on requesting, I will keep on reacting. This is gonna be everything for me. Bye bye, I'll see you in the next one.